Get ready to match the stars from Shanana, Bowzer, Brett Summers, Charles Ghost and Reilly, from Chips, Brianne, Leary, from The Prize is Right, Bob Barker, and George Bulifant, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 79. And now, here's the star of Match Game 79, Gene Rayburn!
Here, but he's very
hello there. Nice of you to join us.
Are you all ready to join us? What is this here?
Proof.
Oh, there is a magazine.
That magazine that she
mentioned used
the
that
other
word
day.
The other day. And there is a
and
magazine called
laughed at me.
Tiger Beat, and we all laughed. Said, what kind of magazine is it?
She
yes.
had that made
she
up.
Had...
I've been wearing Bowzer all week in his basic black, and
yes.
I wondered if he'd wear these.
Oh, yes.
Oh, Joyce, thank you so much.
Don't get him greasy.
That's way it. Over my head?
That's right.
Pretty.
Okay, is this right or should I double them up?
Perfect.
Okay, Joyce, thank you.
Beautiful.
I really appreciate it.
Yeah. All right. Is it going to affect your singing voice? Am I going to have to do the part? Boom, 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 boom.
That's pretty good, Gene.
Yeah.
Want to try to do a little choreography here?
Yeah.
Boom, 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 now we'll sing Blue Moon, we'll go way down. Oh, I know we'll sing Magic.
Okay. Gotcha. Okay. You're wonderful. Listen, Vince, how do you feel today?
Fine.
He's got $600, this fella has, and he's hoping to win more.
Either $5,000 or $10,000. Because he started the audience match and he won the $500, that means he's going to be the least he'll play for is $5,000.
So we want to get him to spin the wheel right now. So you want to come around over here, please, if you would, please. All right. Now stand over here in the blue dot. Go! Watch it all happen. There it is. Isn't that nifty? What power we have here. And that thing is going around there. Well, you've done that part of it. Now come up here. Stand right up there in the little spot there. It must make one complete revolution. If it stops in the gold star area, you'll be playing for $10,000. Good luck, Vince. Okay, $5,000 here with John Bowzer. Shana.
Lucky I have the poils on. That's all I can say.
You got the lucky poils on?
I got the lucky poils.
Okay, here we go. The Greek blank. The Greek blank. Okay. Now, Bowzer's finished. If you give us the answer that he's already written on that card, we give you $5,000. The Greek...
Tycoon.
The Greek tycoon. Okay. He said the Greek tycoon will match you for the $5,000. What do you say to that?
I thought of it after I thought of the other one, and I should have changed it because I knew it was the right answer, and I said gods.
The Greek gods. Well, that's a good one. The Greek god, Greek gods. No. That's okay.
I'm sorry.
Take back your
the poils didn't wait. He's slipping right out of your hand there. Vince, you've got $600, and you're going to meet another player a little bit. Right now, we want to do a little business with America. We'll see how you do a little later. Watch this, if you please. Ready. Let's all briskly applaud our new player, Chris Frary. We welcome you. Now, you want to get acquainted with you, Chris? Tell us where you're from. Anything you want to contribute will be acceptable.
I'm a student in the Bay Area, and I am a painter, and I had my first one-person painting show recently in
How
San Francisco.
Wonderful. That's an exciting event, isn't it? what sort of painting do you do?
They are big, very large, abstract paintings.
Abstract expressionism.
Mm-hmm.
You're a very expressionistic lady there. Good luck to you, Chris. We'll begin by asking you to select A or B in the first round.
I'll go for B.
B it is. All right. She says. Phil said. Phil said, when I was a kid, we were too poor to afford a dog.
Oh.
So I taught my blank to chase cars.
Break my heart.
Right. Put it in the slot if you would, Brianne.
Oh, gosh, I'm sorry.
And
I always forget.
Away we go.
Rocket scientist.
Phil said, when I was a kid, we were too poor to afford a dog, so I taught my blank to chase cars.
Baby brother.
Brother. Okay. He said, little brother.
I love it.
And what, how many people booed?
Quite
many?
A few. Yeah, many.
Many?
Yes.
Well, great minds think alike. And besides, I was also too poor to afford a dog, so I taught my little brother how to chase cars.
Chris. Little brother?
Let him boo both of us. We made money.
Wonderful answer. I wish I thought of it. I said I taught about Roach.
Yeah! I think you're on your prayer roll, too. What do you say?
I beg your pardon.
Yes.
What are you supposed to do? Match, right?
Yeah, match. That's the whole idea.
Oh, like this?
Yes, precisely. Well done. Two for Chris. Brianne?
Little brother.
Little brother. Excellent. Yes.
They booed at first for Bowzer's answer of brother, but audience, you'll know that that is the right answer now. It's brother.
That's right. Now, one person said, I taught my cat to chase cars. Now, one person said,
because that stinks.
You can't afford a dog. You can't afford a cat.
Aren't they a lovable bunch? All right. Got one for you, Vince. Here it is. Hang in there. Weird Willie is so weird. When he goes camping, he doesn't sleep in a sleeping bag. He sleeps in a blank bag. How weird he is. All right, next person. Weird Willie is so weird, when he goes camping, he doesn't sleep in a sleeping bag. He sleeps in a blank bag.
Doggy.
Yeah!
Doggy bag. Now, that's funny. It's not going to get him anywhere, but it's very funny.
I understood he was so poor when he was a little boy, he didn't have a dog.
That's your one beat behind.
Oh,
there.
That's
right.
The story of my life.
Go to sleep now.
Yes. Okay.
My name is Bowzer, so I couldn't bring myself the right doggy bag.
Right.
I don't want Weird Willie in my bag, so I wrote plastic.
A plastic bag, okay.
That is weird.
Yes.
I couldn't bring myself to write anything of the before mentioned, so I wrote paper bag.
Yeah! Paper bag.
Yes,
we're looking for a doggy bag.
I had diction lessons, so I wrote garbage.
Garbage bag, okay. Vince is looking for a doggy bag. I thought it was kind of a funny, amusing answer myself. What do you think about
that? It is
that?
Good.
I'm sorry, I said glad bag.
Glad bag is good.
Yeah!
I mean, all of these are good. They're so far.
Happy bag.
I'm a little worried. I've been here for a week with Bowzer, and I'm beginning to think like he does.
A plastic bag. Yeah. That's a good answer. Those are plastic garbage bags, yes.
What was your answer again?
Doggy bag.
Doggy bag!
Yeah. I'm going to round two. Chris, you can have a choice again of A or B.
I like B.
B. All right. Now you've matched everyone
except plays.
Miss Brett up here.
I can't believe they all said baby brother.
Dr. Frankenstein said, yeah. I never should have given my monster the brain from a frog. Now, I can't stop him from blanking.
You don't even have to finish. I got it. Okay. All for all. You just stick it in the slot and let's go.
Do I have to repeat it for you? He says, I never should have given my monster the brain from a frog. Now, I can't stop him from blanking.
Hopping.
Hopping. I don't think I'm going to walk that far because I don't think you two are on the same wavelength.
Evidently not, darling. I said croaking.
Croaking. frogs do hop and they do croak. Both of them are acceptable answers. Vince, the way it is this way. You need four to tie and five to win. Whoops, we're not going to do that. We're going to do a commercial. I'll put it back right here, and we'll put it, hold it in abeyance, Sarah. Watch this message. Here we go. Ready? All right. Now, four to tie, five to win. Bill said, it's strange being married to a seamstress. Every night in bed, she tries to blank me. Strange being married to a seamstress.
A seamstress?
A seamstress. Every night in bed, she tries to blank me. Okay, Vince, here it is. Bill said, it's strange being married to a seamstress. Every night in bed, she tries to blank me.
Hem.
Hem. All right. Him.
Me, I'm a stranger in paradise.
Okay.
Thread.
He's trying to thread me. Now you got to match everybody else to stay in the game, Vince. Here we go. Brett, what have you got?
I'm the villainess as usual.
No doubt.
I'm sorry, I said thread.
Thread. All right, that means Chris Riley wins. What do I say, Chris? Vince Berger will be leaving here with $600 and our thank best you. Wishes. There he goes. Thank you very much for being with us here at Match Game 79. Oh, you're better than my dear.
How do you feel?
I feel great.
Good. Here's the way it goes, Chris. We polled a studio audience not too long ago, and we said, please write down your best answer to this. Vodka blank.
Oh, boy. Right.
If you give us the answer they wrote down most often, you get $500. And if you give us the answer they wrote down second most frequently, $250. And then for matching their third most popular answer, $100, three of the six loonies will help you.
Charles.
Look how giddy she is. You love this question, don't you? Better than deep in the heart of blank or anything.
What a dreadful
she moment. She just loves this question.
You're such an awful
yes.
man.
Vodka and tonic.
Okay. There's one.
Chris. Have another martini with Mother Gabrielle.
Vodka martini is her answer.
Bowzer.
I'd have to say Collins.
Vodka Collins. From a vodka Collins, a vodka martini, and a vodka and tonic. Now, you may choose one of those or reject all three and give us one of your own.
Vodka martini.
You want a vodka martini? Okay. That was Brett's answer. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. We'll begin at the bottom and reveal the $100 number. Well, you got it right off the bat. You got another $100. But I thought it'd be up there a little bit higher. What's under the $250 one? There's the tonic. What do you think's under the big one?
Gimlet. Vodka really? Rock.
What should be Gimlet?
Vodka Rock.
I don't know. Couldn't be Vodka,
vodka
Collins.
Rock.
Okay, slide it, Ori. Who drinks Vodka Collins anymore? Oh, yeah. Wait a minute. Now, if you drink Vodka Collins, have you had one in the last year, raise your hand. Yeah, don't lie to me. They're a bunch of winos. Wrong. Okay.
The people
now,
who
listen,
drink.
You've won $100 multiplied by 10 means at least you'll play for is $1,000. But you can play for $2,000 if you have a lucky spin of the star wheel. There it is. It's all yours. Go. Must make one revolution. That's it. $1,000 or $2,000. I think you got it. A little more. A little more. Yeah. Good. Well done. That's it. Here we go for $2,000. Good luck to you, my dear. It says on this card, blank detective. Blank detective. We appreciate your enthusiasm, but if you say an answer real loud and they hear it, and use it, and it's the wrong one, then you see where you are. All right, you're finished there. If you match her, you get $2,000. Blank detective. Blank detective. Now, wait a minute. Just take a deep breath. And think of the first, say the first thing that comes into your head. Some weirdo in the audience said vodka. Now, don't break her concentration. Blank detective.
Oh, I can't believe it. The easy detective.
Oh, wow.
Right. That's hard of you.
Yeah. She drew a blank. She couldn't
cheap
think of what.
Cheap detective, that was it.
The cheap detective is what you were trying to say?
I couldn't remember it.
Couldn't remember it. All right,
oh,
Brett.
Oh, I'm sorry. I know that feeling isn't, I do it quite frequently. I said the private detective.
Private detective. I would have said house detective or something like that, but there are a number of good choices.
You
there.
Would. That's yes. The one that you would.
That's why right. We're up here. You would be speaking from experience.
So, Chris, you've got $200 total. You'll meet another player a little bit later. Right now, we've got a little message for them. Yep. Johnny Ohm. Let's welcome Olaf Tweedy here. Plug, plug, plug. Olaf Tweedy. Olaf, we welcome you and wish you the best of luck and ask you to tell us a little bit about you, sir.
Well, I'm from Las Vegas, Nevada, the gambling town.
Yeah.
Vegas, huh? Wow. I work as a security officer in one of the casinos. I have a wife and two lovely kids.
Okay. Good luck to you, Olaf. Thank here you. We go. We'll ask you to make a selection here about A or B.
I'll start with B.
You want B. All right. Sally, the secretary, said, my boss has lost his mind. Today in the office, instead of making phone calls, he was making blank calls.
Want to do it again?
Yeah. I know about it.
Sally, the secretary, said, boss has lost his mind. Today in the office, instead of making phone calls, he was making blank calls.
Did you see my kid in Las Vegas? He's there this weekend. I miss him. If you see him, tell him to call his mother.
Okay. But not for money.
He knows better than that.
Okay.
You never call anyone from New England for money.
Now, Sally, the secretary, said, my boss has lost his mind. Today in the office, instead of making phone calls, he was making blank calls.
Dirty calls.
Dirty calls. Or obscene calls, is what he said. Okay. What do you got there?
Phone calls are obscene calls, aren't they?
Not all of them.
Olaf Tweedy. And I thought Bowzer was a peculiar name. I said bird. Bird calls.
He was making voice calls.
Bird.
Yes, Boyd.
That is a fabulous answer.
What?
Boyd.
Bite calls. I think it's a Boyd fabulous
calls. Wonderful
it
answer.
It is a wonderful. Well, I'd like a little more response. He's our guest.
Listen,
he doesn't
John,
come every week.
You know, you're getting better.
That's right. Now tell him.
Terrific. John, terrific.
I love this. Good.
Now, that's
I'm going to send
do
you
I pay
a
you, Brett?
Bucket
sweet.
Of grease.
Bird.
Boyd!
Wonderful answer. Yeah.
Isn't that terrific?
I love you. I said house call.
House call, good. Okay, Olaf is looking for the answer. Obscene phone call, anything like that.
May I say something really quick?
Yeah.
I promise to do this for Ira, my one impersonation. No one else understand, but Ira will understand it. De plan, Both. De plan. Okay, house calls.
Okay, you will explain it later. House calls is good. Bob?
Again, Bowzer and I could make a fortune. Bird call.
Bird call. Right. Well, I suspect he's looking over your shoulder.
Well, I was going to... Well, I hadn't thought of that. Bowzer. I was going to write obscene
No, I wrote
phone
bird.
Call,
he wrote
but
bird.
But you didn't.
But I didn't because that is a phone call.
Right.
They say he wasn't making phone calls.
He's
right.
Too busy making them to write it out.
Go ahead, Joyce.
We have to reason these
I'm
things
still
out.
I'm working on the plane, Bob.
The plane, Bob. The plane.
Oh, I'm sorry. I said cat calls.
Cat calls. So there we are in the middle of round one. Olaf's had his round one question. We'll have one for you, but right now we have this for you.
Need his tennis shoes.
Next time we get together, you will see these stars.
Avery Schreiber! That's Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Elaine Joyce, Gary Berghoff, and Fanny Flagg.
Thank you for joining us on Match Jam 79. Join us next time. Gene Rayburn, you're wonderful. Thank you. Bye.